spiritual impact. That girl, that boy, what spiritual impact has he or she made in your life? What are they teaching you? Smoking, free beer, free shakis. They buy for you. They never give you money, but they buy free drink for you. Are you not tired? Free weed, Indian hemp. That's what they give to you. If you are still here and you are still involved in that, listen to me. Medical precaution. If you are not taking medical precaution to help your health, hell is waiting. You want to smoke? Hell is waiting. There's abundance of fire in hell. Carry weed along. You don't need a lighter. Just go there, carry weed. As you enter, bam, the weed will just light. Then you start smoking for eternity. Some people now is an addiction because somebody introduced them to it. And it takes your money, takes your time, takes your health, takes your pride, takes your dignity as a man. You have to hide to do it. You have to sneak somewhere to do it. Yeah, I mean, it is a problem, it's causing catastrophe. And at this point, who introduced you to it? Who taught you how to do such a thing? That's not a person, that's a friend. That's a destiny killer. That's a destiny destroyer. That's a destiny truncator that you need to avoid. Friends that talk to you about God, friends that when you meet them, they're with the Bible, friends that when you see them, you are challenged, you are inspired, you are challenged to be like them, you are inspired. Somebody saw me in Germany, said, I've known you for 20 years, you are the same, you are the same, you are the same, you are the same. He said, I saw you ministering the word of God and tears ran down my eyes. He said, because growing up, I loved God's word, I was following you about, but somebody came to my life and took me to Europe. He said, Apostle, my life is a mess. He said, I can't tell you. He said, my first wife left me, my second wife left me, the third one just left. I said, you three times, you don't marry three times. He said, Apostle, you have never heard anything. That is the three legal. There are other several illegal. My life is a mess. Through one person that entered into him. And so, why are you carrying the Bible for? Let's go and show you what is in town. Let's show you what is in vogue. And his life is a mess. I looked at him. I said, where do we start from? He said, help me financially. I said, even if I give you money, how does that balance your image? Where do we start from? How many children do you have now? He says 16. I see, how many women? He said about 7 or 8. I said, I don't understand. What is all? He said, there is one. I don't know if that one is my child though. I don't know if that one is my child. I'm still thinking. I said, I don't understand. How? So where do I start supporting you from? He said, even me, I'm confused. How did it begin? One person entered his life and introduced rubbish to him, introduced nonsense to him. See, what is it? We are all in church, and so. There's a way to do this thing, sir. There is a way that seemeth right to a man, but the end of that way is destruction. Proverbs 14:12, Proverbs 16:25. There's a way that seemeth right to a man, but the end of that way is the way of destruction. Hear me. In the church, some people, we want to introduce you to error in the church. They want to introduce you on how to steal money, how to cut corners, how to compromise, how to play games, how to do nonsense. Proverbs 14:12, Proverbs 16:25. There is a way that seemeth right unto a man, but the end you do not. The Bible says, my son, if sinners entice thee, consent thou not. Don't allow anyone introduce you to anything outside Christ. What you will listen to are things that will help your faith, not somebody teaching you how to scam, how to play games, how to become a Yahoo person and make quick money. I've never seen a Yahoo boy that live long. I can tell you, I've never seen any Yahoo person that live long. They make all the money at their young age, either a disease or death. I can count many. I don't want to call names on the altar. I know one of the foremost Yahoo internet fraudsters in those days, in the 80s, the 90s. The last time I saw him in Lagos, he was driving cab. He carried me. Some of you know what I'm talking about. He's a cab driver now. He made money. He will enter a circle. He will buy cars, buy houses, dash people. He drives cab. I said, what happened to you? He said, I ate my today yesterday. You can follow God and be blessed. Look at my life. I'm not a Yahoo man. I don't take money from people. I told somebody on phone yesterday, I said, my greatest joy and that this ministry is one ministry where we do not go after people's money. We are not a ministry that is after people's money. Rather, we spend to help people. If God can bless me, why can't he bless you? I've not defrauded nobody. I've not lied to nobody. I've not cut corners or played games. Am I speaking here? Because I've not defrauded nobody. I have seen people. I have
have seen them meet me, say, what do we do? Pray for us. Do we give you this? I say, no. I have turned down favors and I'm blessed. So blessed to the teeth. Blessed to the teeth. Am I speaking to somebody here? And I have no church money in my pocket. I'm not arrogant. I'm not proud. I'm saying it as it is. I am blessed. Am I talking to somebody here? In my young life, I have seen money. What you call money? If you think I'm lying, if you see money, ask money. Am I talking to somebody here? I have seen the blessing of God. Why? Because when you follow God and stand by God, He blesses you.